think so, yeah.
Yeah, I can just see then.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Take a shortcut.
Yeah.
Well, we'll come back anyway. Oh.
Yeah, what's the rock?
Yeah. Oh, it gets deeper here. 8 feet.
8 feet, wow, it's deep.
Yeah. I think that's why they sent to put a life jacket on. They were sent to put a life jacket onto them. Or a vest.
I'm going to go down.
Oh, so this must be it. We're in the apiary. We're inside the apiary now. We're inside the apiary. It's on there.
So you can get in and walk about.
Yeah.
This is nice, isn't it? Are you alright?
Yeah.
There's a lot of drag about.
I know.
She's
turning
on you.
I know. Never mind when it gets deep, it should warn you when it gets shallow.
Let's get on the bus to you.
Oh, there's a squirrel up there.
Look,
alright. You see the squirrel?
No.
On top.
Oh my god, right there.
Right above you.
Oh yeah, it's sitting there. Look at that car.
Kookaburra.
Where?
Just up there.
1, 2, 3. Lovely. It's really nice. No, with the glass.
Okay, just up there.
Yeah.
I need to stop there. Don't just step on it.
Yeah.
I know.
Thank you. Rouge. They're related to raccoons. Did you want to touch her? And then if you're just joining us again, her name is Miela. She's called a Kinkajou. They're, happy birthday. They're native to Central and South America out in the rainforest. Touching him on his lower back. If you have any questions about him or Miela that you saw earlier, let me know, okay? Yeah. These animals that you're seeing today are considered animal ambassadors. So a lot of times they're going off property to schools and other educational talks. So if we had like an exhibit where they were living out where you guys could see, you'd probably be pretty disappointed because oftentimes they're not here. So they do have a habitat, an indoor and outdoor habitat, located behind our scenes. And of course, when they are on property, we do our best to... Yep.